All right, we are back. You are back. Thank you for joining us. This is episode 61, I think. I'm kind of losing track, and it's Tommy's fault if it isn't 61. All right, anyways, well, in the past two episodes, we've been looking at what Paul says about false teaching and false teachers, and hopefully you've been able to see that this isn't something that's small or insignificant. This isn't something that we can just kind of sweep under the rug and go, I'll deal with that later. Paul's language is so strong and even shocking. He calls this worldly, empty chatter. This is godless. It's a disease that spreads like gangrene. He even names names like Hymenaeus and Philetus, and it's such a powerful reminder that we can't be weak on this. You know, you can mess up tying a bow tie. You can mess up a shopping list and bring the wrong kind of chicken home on accident or whatever, but you can't mess this up. We can't get this wrong. We have to handle false teachers rightly. We have to think about this biblically, and we have to act biblically. And that will mean drawing a line in the sand. That will mean being firm and unmoving. It will mean that we treat false teachers and false teaching as a disease, and as such that we cut them out of the body. And if someone says, wow, that's mean, that's not nice, so be it. The church needs to be pure. And pastors and lay people alike, we have the responsibility to protect the flock. Now, does this mean that you should be mean and that you find a false teacher and you scream at him and you hit him in the face? Of course not, right? Wisdom is slow to anger, and our speech should always be full of grace and seasoned with salt, Colossians 4, verse 6. But if we're to carry out and carry on Paul's legacy, if we're to train the next generation and do all that God has required of us, we're going to need a backbone. Even if it's hard, even if we're scared about coming across as mean, we need to have the kind of conviction that enables us to do the right thing, even if it's hard. And all this brings us to verse 18, where Paul continues this discussion of false teachers, specifically relating to Hymenaeus and Philetus. So let's get into it. Verse 18. Hymenaeus and Philetus, they are men, look at this, they are men who have gone astray from the truth, who have gone astray from the truth. The idea here of have gone astray is probably closer to the idea of abandoning. It's that they know what the truth is, but guess what? These guys don't care. That it's not that they were ignorant of the truth. These guys, they made their decision and they walked away from it. They're not trying to get closer to the truth. They're trying to get as far away from it as possible. And what is so chilling and almost eerie is that these guys can even look good on the outside. They could be friendly. These guys could have big smiles, great personality, and people can love them, and they could treat you so well, better than most people. But Paul says, make no mistake, these guys aren't really your friends. Paul, he unveils the mask, and he goes behind the scenes. He pulls back the curtain, and he shows you who these guys truly are. They try to kill people spiritually. And more than not caring and abandoning the truth and deception, these guys, worst of all, they waged war against God's word. Against God's word. What they say is poison. It's toxic, and it leads to death. Look at what they said, saying that the resurrection has already taken place. For Paul, the doctrine of the resurrection is not just a doctrine, it is the doctrine. That is Paul's everything. If you deny the resurrection, it's over. Why? Because the resurrection proves that Jesus Christ is the Son of God and the Son of David. It demonstrates his power and his dominion over sin and death, and it is the vindication of God's righteousness. And it's on the basis of Jesus' resurrection that believers, that all believers, will be resurrected and perfected with an imperishable, eternal life in the end. The resurrection is what ensures all believers a future and final victory over sin and death. It is the anchor of our faith. It is the source of our hope and our assurance. It is what we press on toward with a clean heart and a blameless conscience. It is what we run the race for. And if you want to learn more, look at all these verses right here. All right. And to all of this, guess what Hymenaeus and Philetus said? What are you talking about? No, that's all done. That's in the past. You guys missed the boat. This is all there is, just right here and right now. All that stuff that you've been hearing about the resurrection, it's over. It's not true for you all. It's false. And Paul says, false teaching. False teachers. And in turn, look at what Hymenaeus and Philetus did as false teachers. And they upset the faith of some. This idea of upset should probably be something along the lines of overturned. It's that they overturned people's faith. It's not just messing some things up. It's a complete overturn. It's a complete overhaul. Hymenaeus and Philetus, these guys ruined people's walks with the Lord. Their entire system of life and all that ensues from holding fast to Scripture, these guys killed that. False teaching and false teachers, they don't just hurt, they destroy. They will try to kill everything in a person's spiritual life. And Hymenaeus and Philetus, these guys even succeeded in doing that. And so no matter what your role is in the church, maybe you teach Awana, maybe you do sound stuff, stacking chairs, women's ministry, you work with missions, whatever it may be, whatever it is, we all bear the responsibility to heed these words, to handle false teachers rightly, and to keep the church pure.
All right, that was episode 61. We're 97.34% sure on that, hopefully. All right, we have two questions for you today. No reading time, no discussion time, just regular old question time. Back to the good old normal days. The first one is, false teachers cause spiritual death. What is the difference between spiritual death and physical death, and why would that matter to us? And then the second question is that Paul hangs his hat and the entire crux of his ministry on the physical resurrection of Jesus. Why is that so important, and why would Paul do that? All right, those are our two questions. We will see you all tomorrow.